Hi, my name is Gala. I'm a Google Data Studio expert, and today I would like to continue to talk about blended data in Google Data Studio. In the first videos, we already talked about what is that blending data source, how to create blended data source in Google Data Studio, and today I would like to put attention to different types of joins. So, as we remember, we have five types of joins. This is a picture. We have left outer, right outer, inner, full outer, and cross joins. Let's see on examples how does it work. We have two tables, Google Ads and Facebook Ads. And Google Ads, it is a left table. Facebook Ads for us is a right table. And left join, we take all data from left table and try to find matches on the right table. I will do sort by date. That will be easier to understand. So, in Google Ads table, we have four rows. In the left join table, we have four rows. Good. Here we have 9, 6, 5, and 4. And on the left table, left join, we have 9, 6, 5, and 4. So, the same as we have in a Google table. And we have cost parameter here. And you see that for Google table, we have cost for all dates. And here we have all dates. But in Facebook, we don't, in the left join table, we have null for 9th of August. Because on Facebook ads table, we don't have 9th of August. We have only 7 and 6, 5 and 4. So Google didn't find any row for 9th of August in the Facebook table and added here no. No, it means we don't have information. I can click here. I can click my data sources left join. I can just show you that it is left table to the Google, right table to the Facebook, and condition here we merge join data by date and I choose left join. Okay, close. The same situation with right join. It is absolutely the same way of working, but we take all rows from the right table instead of left. And in this case, I will do sort by date. Our Facebook table, it is right table. So we have here four rows again, because Facebook table has four rows and it is 7, 6, 5, and 4 as a Facebook table has 7, 6, 5, and 4 of August. And on the right table, we have cost for all Facebook, for all days in Facebook. We have cost for 7 of August. And here we have data because Facebook, it is right, Facebook ads, it is the right table. But Google doesn't have information for 7 of August. So we have null here for 7 of August. So, you can think already that which data is more accurate for us. What can we do more? We have three types of joins more. Inner join. Inner join match only rows that we can find in the left and the right table. So we can see that in Google table we have 9 that Facebook doesn't have, and 6, 5, and 4. And Facebook table has 7 and 6, 5, and 4. So 6, 5, and 4 of August are common for both table, and 9 and 7 are not. So for inner join, we will have only 3 rows in the table that we can find in both tables. And the result is here. We have only 3 rows, 6, 5, and 4 of August. And here we exclude data from 7 and 9. Full outer join works opposite. Here we have all data from left table and all data from the right table. And if we cannot find some data to match, we will put null. And here we will have 5 rows. Because I added here Facebook date and Google date, because here in this case they are different. And here we have, for Google date, we have 4 rows that we have in Google and 4 rows that we have in Facebook. But for 9th of August, we have null for Facebook date and null for Facebook cost. And for 7th of August, we have null for Google date and null for Google cost. But in total, we have all rows. And I will do sort by Google date. Okay. And the more rare to use join, it is cross join. I almost don't use in my practice, maybe in some rare cases, but anyway, it's better to know how does it work. In cross join, let's go up to our main tables. In a cross join, we take the first row from Google table and multiply it for the number of rows in a Facebook table. So we will have 9th of August from Google and 7th of August from Facebook. Then again 9th of August from Google with 6th of August from Facebook. Again 9th of August from Google and then 5th of August from Facebook. So it will be multiply all rows from one table with all rows from other tables. And we have 4 and 4. In total we will have 16 rows. Four rows for 9th of August, 4 rows for 6th of August, 4 rows for 5th and 4th. Let's take it here. I think it's more obvious here. So 9th of August, in Google, we had 72 euros cost. 9th of August, we had, doesn't matter. In the so we already have multiply something. Ah, yeah, sure, because you have multiplies everything, so we have twice amount for everything. And so we have 9th of August. Here 7th of August. 9, 6, 9, 4, 9, 4. And again for next day from Google we have again 4 rows from Facebook. And the same. And because of that, the numbers are a bit weird, but sometimes this cross-join works, but it's even cannot create any nice example for it. But anyway, and when we created join, we can use it not only for table, we can create nice chart like here, for example, we can create and we can see dates and Google and Facebook data in one chart, or even we create filter with this data. So basically, we can use it as a normal data source, but with information from different ads platform, for example. Hope it was helpful for you. Will be nice to hear any feedback. And bye. See you soon.